Welcome to another episode of Dungeons After Dark. Our newest campaign.
How dare you?
Dungeons and Detectives. Old habits die hard. You want to introduce yourselves?
Entire
backstory, just the first page.
I'm Chris. I'm Sir Gareth Sprot, dickhole detective. I think that sums me up.
I'm Dextar Woods, a furball game warden of sorts on loan.
And I'm playing Conan Shields, a grizzled old detective who's just tired of this shit. And, as always, our forever DM.
Did you do something new with your hair, David? It looks good, man. It's like...
We're always talking about his hair.
I mean, it looks like he did something new with it.
I mean, he's a very snazzy dresser, too.
Yeah.
I washed it.
How about that horizontal striped shirt, though?
I love it. It makes you look very thin. It's very flattering
very
on your
wide,
form.
Just like stacked.
Yeah.
Beefy. Triangular.
So I washed my hair and did push-ups this evening.
Oh,
so.
Wow. It shows.
Our perception is on a roll this morning.
It shows.
It's not going to say anything, though, because I am the DM, David Spradley, and I'm here to kill you all.
Oh, nee.
I remember.
I keep trying.
Yeah.
It's worked once.
Yeah, it's worked once.
We've been going down a lot this campaign.
Yeah, we have.
All of us.
It's like we learned nothing that first campaign.
create one.
So to catch everyone up, in a singular day, they went to a vineyard, killed one of the seven big bosses, almost got killed themselves, went to a creepy mansion.
We saved some children.
Saved some children from some giant evil crustaceans.
And then we almost burned them to death.
The crustaceans or the children?
Both.
That's true. Yeah, you blew up a crawfish hole and survived to tell about it. Went to the hospital where some hijinks ensued. Sprott has a date at some point in the near future. because he got...
With Larry.
He got discounted drugs for it, but she sort of threatened his person if he didn't make good on the date.
Yeah.
We'll see how that goes. It'll probably happen next time.
On Dragon Ball Z. I mean, Dungeons and Detectives.
So after the hospital visit, the kids were saved. Woo, good job. They got some side quests from the creepy house... creepy house owner and his housemates of the mansion, which probably won't happen this time either. Oh, look, it's a phone call. And let's see. Yeah, they got out of the hospital and back to the station. They want to go after a rich pig merchant.
Tilda
Swainson.
We're coming for her.
Which is in reference to any actress.
No.
Who's a real person. And so they want to go after her, and Chief says, hey, I'll give you a warrant. I'll tell her we're throwing her a party. She'll come to the station. You go look for, you know, evil shit at her place. You find it. You call me. I put her in a jail cell. Seems simple, right?
Yeah.
Nothing's too simple for us, though.
Nothing is as it
seems.
It has
so many connotations.
Nothing is too simple for
us.
Yeah. So, you bunch of simps, you've just had this conversation with Cece, and you're standing in the station. What is your plan of action? You have a warrant in your hand?
We do. Well, Cece...
We have a warrant to enter, but we don't have a warrant to arrest her.
No, Cece is being... He's going out to there, and he's going to bring her back.
We're a party.
Yeah, and we're supposed to tail Cece without getting caught. Uh-huh. So you're the driver. You're going to have to make sure that goes correctly.
Yeah.
And then once we get close to the estate, we need to hide. And then once they're clear out of sight, we need to survey, make sure that there's no, people on the estate, anything
going
like
quiet,
that. Yeah. Go quiet and get in and recover some evidence if we can, and. As soon as we get something that's incriminating, we'll call Cece and he'll throw her in jail.
Yeah.
Okay. But we need
to get there case to pace. Okay. Cece, do we have anything in the impound lot? Something that would fit in with the area up there? Because I know it's kind of out in the country, but it's a little fancier, you know?
What are you looking for here, boys?
I'm talking something sleek, tinted windows.
A gins.
Something that's not his ostentatious silver bullet.
Yeah, not
a
Mercedes gins.
Oh, all right, okay.
You got a Cadillac?
Well, you know what? Actually, we are going to like a really rich part of town. We do need like something like a Cadillac.
I'm telling you.
That way we will, yeah. We can't be going in the busted old
something,
man.
Something made in the last 2-3 years.
You know, I've worked at this place for 40 years. I just put my first down payment on her. Nah, I can't trust you guys with it. No, I couldn't.
But, are you sure, boss?
I was gonna pick her up in it. You know, it'd look real good.
Oh yeah, no, that's you need to do that. Well,
I mean, unless you can offer me some other way to pick her up, at it.
I mean, she'd be more likely to get into that. Do you is there anything that we got?
There's the governor. Governor.
That two-bit taxi driver.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't know if we should do that, though.
He does have a nice ride, though. He's a little too fancy for my taste. When I order a taxi, I want something yellow and squealing.
It's real small, though, too. It's real small, if y'all remember right. And I don't know.
But, it would fit into the neighborhood.
But do we need anybody else?
Do you have
any
service vans? Like,
you telling me you don't know anybody with a nice ride?
Besides him?
Well, Slither has a nice ride, but he's going to want a favor for it if we ask him something.
Slither? You've had dealings with Slither. If I know him right, you already owe him favors.
Nah, I don't.
God, I'd like to get my hands on him. I'd like to bust his balls and put him in the clink.
That's telling.
He's just so slippery. Does have a nice ride, though. Anyways, so you can't borrow mine. Got to pick her up in it.
Come on, there's got to be something just hanging out in the impound. You catch anybody on tax evasion?
I'm telling you, I don't think I have anything. Not right now.
Oh, you got those paints.
I guess we can just paint my car.
Yeah, we can paint
your
car.
You really, know, I was getting tired of that color anyway.
Yeah. I mean, it's got a sidecar on it and everything, and it's not just the paint, it's the whole overall form of it, too, you know? It's like...
It's a hot ride.
If you look
smash.
At what those pigments can do, it makes things. It builds things. Like, you can create 3D objects out of it.
Oh, yeah?
You can make it look like a different vehicle.
Okay, well, I'm going to hand you one, then, and you do it.
What is this?
Sounds like y'all got this figured out. I'm going to head on up the road and go get her.
We'll be right behind you. All right.
Just remember that if you see me coming the other way, to duck your heads.
Oh yeah, for sure.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right. So would that be a performance check to paint it up, right?
No, get out of the way. Get out of the way.
I see that. This is like when people like take a Honda that's a POS 4 banger and then put like a
cardboard spoiler on it.
And, you know, all this stuff.
Are you saying Conan's ride is a Honda?
No. I'm just saying y'all are going to make it look...
Oh, we're going to make it look like
You can
like
make
a
it
Honda.
Look completely different with these paints. They have that ability.
Oh, okay. Yeah. I'm going to shape it into like a Toyota Tercel.
Yeah, what's your performance?
Plus five. No, wait. Zero.
So you're out
I got a plus two.
You're out in the garage down there trying to slap some paint on it. It's like working with clay almost.
I got a 14.
And you're trying to form it into stuff that looks good, and it's just, it's got humps in the wrong places, and then you hear,
you fellas didn't like the paint job?
No, Gigi, we gotta put it under cover. Can you change it back when
Gigi,
we get done?
Help us out with this.
Yeah, I've got some solvent after we lost that last bit. What do you want to make her look like?
Black on black. Let's murder.
Black on black. Murder it out. Make it look
limo tint.
Make it look like a chauffeur is driving it.
Okay, so you want something a little fancier?
A little fancier.
A town car.
Yeah.
Should we detach the sidecar?
Yeah.
We could have one of us come in on a motorcycle. Eh?
Yeah.
All right.
Make the motorcycle look a little more normal.
Give me 20 minutes with her, and I think I could do something.
Can it steer on its own?
Huh?
The sidecar can steer on its own?
Yeah, it's a motorcycle with a steam ball.
Oh.
It got upgraded after that.
Oh, that's right.
That horrendous wreck.
That's right, yeah.
The old sidecar got blown to bits.
I mean, I'm like...
with Sprot in it.
I lift up his mask. He's like, oh, that's right.
which we learned.
You haven't got that looked at?
We learned last episode you killed the parents of a poor young girl.
Yeah, apparently.
Poor little Sally.
Yeah, I mean, maybe
you make that
don't
happen,
stand in
David.
The middle of the street when there's a wreck happening.
You,
I don't know.
Like you,
they were in the fruit truck driving the other way.
Yeah.
You careened into them.
He's risk of the business.
He's telling his truth, David. He's telling his truth.
Oh, yeah. So y'all go back after giving him 20 minutes?
Yeah. I'm like 8 feet tall, so I think I'm going to ride the bike because that car's real cramped.
Yeah, that makes sense to me.
I'm real tall.
Yeah, it looks great. He has done matte black. He has completely changed the configuration of your grill. There appears to be chrome stripping, chrome on the wheels. There's an antenna where there didn't used to be one. Don't know what that's for. It looks pretty good. Pretty good. The sidecar now has fenders over the wheels. Big old wide,
so
fancy
Gigi,
fenders.
So, Gigi, this paint, like... It's just like a shell over the car, right?
Yeah.
So how does it hold up? Like, is it going to stay around, or is it something that can be ripped off or blown off?
It can be smashed off or blown off or ripped off. Or like I said, though, I've got solvent here
magical
to wash
solvent.
It all clean.
Okay. Looks good. I mean, it'll pass in the night. All right, boys. Who's gonna ride behind?
I'll ride with you, and he's going to take the motorcycle.
Yeah, I'm real tall. It's
Dude, that motorcycle's going to look like a mini bike underneath you.
I know, but it's hard for me to fit in there in the first place.
I don't know. That seems a little... sticks out a little bit.
I mean, he can disguise himself really well.
Yeah, that's right. That's right. Yeah, you got your little freaky... Don't turn into a bear, though. You look like you came out of a circus.
Hey, that might be above suspicion, you know? It might look so silly that...
All right, y'all ready? Let's catch up to CC and... And tell what this is going to be weird.
A bear and a motorcycle? That doesn't seem like a good idea.
Like the circus, like I said.
Da, 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 da,
you see him go around in the circle?
Sounds like Russia to me.
Yeah. It's very much. Yeah. Yeah. Very much so.
So we're going to head on down the country road.
Yeah.
Country roads.
I didn't bring that word.
To the place.
Have we rested?
I will die.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay.
Oh, yeah. West Virginia. Mountain mama, and take me home.
Country road.
All right, so let's get on down the road, boys.
So we're going on the road. I'm looking to see. I know the route that he's taking, so I'm trying to get up ahead and just like, I'm going to use my cop vision, my perception, and I'm going to roll.
That's a superpower. It is.
And I'm going to see if I can just spot where he is. And I got a 12.
See where
13,
is.
Where CC is. I'm trying to catch up to him. So I don't want to get too close.
Oh,
I see. That's what he told us to do anyway.
When you are three quarters of the way there, you see CC coming towards you.
We all duck. Put your heads down.
Give me sleight of hand checks at disadvantage.
I run off. I want to run off the road.
Why disadvantage?
Because you ducked while you were driving.
I'm not ducking. I run off.
Nine.
Okay.
You said sleight of hand?
Yeah.
I got an 8.
Oh, yeah. So you can't even help him drive better. So y'all both duck down and y'all hit each other's heads and then you hear honk honk. And then when you come back up, you see CC like sort of ran off the road a little bit because you had crossed the center line when you were ducking.
I just went off road, yeah.
Did you?
Yeah, I rode dirt bikes as a kid, so.
Okay, you don't have to. Yours is not a disadvantage.
Oh, okay.
What'd you get?
What is it? A sleight of hand?
Yeah, that's your driving check.
I got a 5.
So. When you saw him coming, you were like, let's get it. I've been on a four-wheeler before. And you just veer off the road, thinking that there's like somewhere for you to go, a little side patch. And you see a little mound, and you're like, oh, yeah, sweet, a jump. And then you just slam into a pile of manure.
Okay.
What's your disguise?
I didn't have one.
Oh, you didn't?
That's why I ran off the road.
Yeah.
Well, now you look like shit.
It's all right. It's all right. I'm cool with it.
So I'll pick my head up and I'll get back to driving.
Yep.
I'm gonna pull the bike out and get back on the road.
Yep.
Yeah.
Good job. You guys didn't get seen. That's wonderful. Awesome.
All right. So we have our address. I'm assuming we know where we're going.
Yes.
What are we looking at layout wise? Like, is it a mansion? Does it have a circular driveway? Is there a back entrance we're approaching? Like, what do we know about it?
So, you know that it's called Porkland Ranch. And
that's not a brothel.
There is a small carnival there with like a carousel but with pigs on it instead of horses. Kids love to go there. It's a nice big
is this like
pretty
Neverland
house. I said
ranch?
It was Porkland Ranch,
yeah,
okay?
Okay. All right.
Porkland Ranch. There's not a prostitution ring running out of this that you know of.
Okay.
But the house is very fancy. It's like a mock castle. But like a castle that like a 17-year-old princess built. So it's a lot of light blues and pinks and
pastels.
Thank you. You know, crenellations, high peaks, points. It's very beautiful. And you know that about a mile away on the property, because a lot of acres, is where she keeps the pigs, because you can't have the pigs close to the house or everything's going to smell horrible.
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So the main entrance, big old gate, you run down to Porkland Ranch, and then you go further on down another mile to reach where she keeps the, you know, the pigs.
So it's okay. A gate, then the pork farm, and then her house.
No, gate, house, pork farm.
Okay.
Yeah.
So
gatehouse, then pork farm behind it. Yeah.
Yeah.
So I guess do y'all want to stop before we get to the gate? Y'all want to cruise by the gate and scope it out?
Well, I can't talk to you on a motorcycle.
We got Sending Stone.
it's like simple phrases.
You're just following us. What do you think?
I say we should go in. We need as much time as possible, and we have a warrant.
I'm just gonna follow them.
Do we have a warrant?
Yeah, we have a warrant.
Wow. Okay. Yeah. Let's go. We don't have a warrant. We're trying to.
No, you definitely have obtained
a warrant.
Okay. From
yeah, we have.
I just didn't write that down.
I only mentioned it at the top of the episode.
Yeah.
Shows what good my notes do. So we're gonna just drive on right in there. Do y'all want to just stop right in front of the house and bust in?
I'm just following y'all. I can't hear you.
So the gate leading in is shut, and there is a small guard hut.
Okay.
All right. So we stop at the guard hut. Do you want to take care of this, or do you want me to?
Yeah, go ahead.
All right.
Do I know all the stuff you just described? Does my character know the layout, or can I see the layout myself?
You have this basic information from Amy.
Okay, I'm gonna see them going to the guard hut and like looking at it. Looking at that there's a guard there and them, and knowing that I'm covered in filth and look very suspicious, I'm just going to keep going past them to the way where I'm outside. I'm going to park the bike like by the fence, and I'm going to jump over the fence and head towards the pig farm.
Okay.
So I'm just going to like, I look silly. I'm not going to, whatever they're doing, I'm going to create a diversion. So I'm headed towards the pigs.
I'm headed towards the guard.
Okay, give me a stealth check.
It's a 12.
Are you jumping out?
Yeah, I'm out of the car.
Should I pull up?
For now.
Yeah.
And try to. I'm gonna pull up and just like act like I'm trying to get in there normally.
Okay, so there's a gate. The gate's shut. It's a big old crossbar across it.
You jump in whenever I distract them.
And a dwarf comes walking out of the little, you know, guard shack thing. And he's got a big cigar in his mouth, and he's wearing lederhosen.
Hey.
Guten Morgen.
Hi there.
Yeah?
Hey, I hear this is where I can get a good porkin. Oh, yeah, you know, I came down from the Northern Territories, and I just wanted to get a good porkin, you know?
Is that what they call it? What's that slang for? You looking for a cutlet?
Oh, you know the old In and Out, yeah.
Sausage? Looking for pork sausage?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Pork. Yep. The pork's. Yeah. Right. Sausage would be nice. Yeah.
So you're coming for a tour.
Yeah. Yeah. Tours are not. Yeah.
Okay.
Flight,
so what was the name? What was the name on the tour? I'll check my sheet.
What are you wanting me to do? Tell me on the paper.
I punch him in the face.
You punch this dwarf in the face?
He's the guard, right?
Yes.
I punch him in the face. Take him out. Like,
I thought we were showing him the warrant, but all right.
Oh.
Okay. So take a swing. Take an attack. Give me an unarmed strike against him.
13 plus my strength.
Yeah.
Yeah, 12.
Oh, you have a -1 to strength? Okay.
All right, I put my cloak over his head.
Well, no, that's initiative.
Yeah.
When he cracks him across the jaw, because he does connect.
Yeah.
Roll a d4 damage.
While they're starting initiative,
One point of damage.
I'm just going to do a ritual to speak with animals. So that's all I'm doing.
Okay.
Okay.
And you, so you're in like a bush line.
Yeah.
And you can tell that about 100 yards up, it opens up into a clearing.
Okay.
And there's a small pond.
I just want to stop and do a little quick speak with animals ritual so I can cast it.
How long does that take?
10 minutes.
10 minutes. Okay. All right. Give me another stealth roll.
That's the same 12.
Okay. So, initiative, what'd you get?
Initiative? Nat 20.
Wow.
22. Modified 23.
I got a dirty 20.
Ah, okay.
I'm so sorry, guys. I completely misunderstood the point. I'm expecting a court martial.
Somebody needs to go to the department psychologist.
Yeah. I would roleplay that.
I thought we were hitting him.
Guys, I thought we were sneaking. I'm sorry.
Did you give me a roll too? While we're at it.
What kind of roll?
Initiative. Again, sir.
Nine.
You can keep playing that. That was good. I like it. So he's just...
It's definitely not copyrightable.
You crack him across the jaw, and he's just like, oh, what was that for? I didn't say it. What are you doing? And, it's your turn, Shields.
I guess I'm just going to apologize.
Go for it.
No, I'm going to grapple him.
Okay.
And put him under arrest. And I got a nat 20, so I have advantage on this attack, right?
No, don't put him under arrest. That's going to, like, create so many headaches for us.
Why?
We got to do this by the book, or
we don't know who's all
screwed.
Involved. When do you secure this guy? We don't know how dangerous he is.
I'm just the gate guy. I was going to check for your name
on
the list.
No,
I'm
arresting him. No, because
here.
Every time we've gone to investigate anybody involved in this, and she is a lead suspect, we have been attacked.
God,
so
yeah,
I'm not taking any chances.
Getting
I'm not losing
my
fucking
my
eye again. Yeah, I handcuff him. Slide a hand check.
How hard it is to wash blood out of lederhosen.
Slide a hand check for, or do I got to roll a grapple?
What are you trying to do to him?
I'm trying to arrest him, so I gotta grab him.
You trying to put him in cuffs?
Yeah, help me.
Tell him you're under arrest.
Let him
you're
help.
Under arrest.
You attempt to grapple.
You're under arrest.
He goes, what for? What for?
Just put your hands behind your back, and I grab his hands and put them behind his back.
You no, wow, you attempt to grapple.
I got a 2. -1, I got a 1. Modified 1.
So he goes to grab him, and he just kind of shakes him off, and he goes... I don't know what's going on here.
Doesn't matter.
And it's your turn.
All right. I show him the arrest warrant. Or the warrant.
And he goes, oh, okay. Let me take a look at that. Okay. Yep. Uh-huh. Yeah, pressure at the premises. Cease and desist. Be arrested if you're... Okay. All right, why didn't you show me this to begin with?
I was going to.
Jesus.
No, I mean, he's still going in handcuffs, though.
You're going to be detained.
Can I see them through the bush?
What if someone else tries to come through the front door?
Well, they're not getting in this time.
I got to watch the gate.
We're
going to
lock the door. We're going to lock
the
door behind
now.
You.
Aaron. I'm sorry, Woods, you're doing your ritual. And about 5 minutes through it, you see a pig, a boar with large tusks, sniffing through the brush. And he's got a collar on him, and he's got goggles on.
Oh, hey, little feller.
And he's just sniffing. And you say that?
No, I'm just under my breath. Yeah.
And he orients on you and just starts charging you.
I'm not through my ritual yet?
No. No, you're halfway through.
I wild shape into a pig.
I wish I could have seen you shopping to the Kids R Us for these.
And I still smell like shit from the bike rack, too. So.
Male or female pig?
I'm a male pig.
Okay. So, the boar, you see him
I'm a boar, but yeah, I'm a boar.
The boar slides to a stop. And it's kind of confused for a minute. And it's looking around. And it walks up to you and it starts sniffing you. And sniffing you. And he's looking around. And he just kind of wanders off into the woods. Sniffing around.
I'm just a pig, man.
You're just a pig, man. Okay, pig. Cool. Back to the guy.
I didn't finish my ritual, though.
With the warrant. You can continue to... can you?
I don't think so.
It would take another 10... Well, you don't lose a spell slot for that, do you?
Mm-mm.
No, you just pull it off if you take another 10 minutes.
Yeah, I'm done. I'm done with it.
Okay.
So we're going to take you in the car on the other side of this gate, and we're going to lock the gate. Nobody else will come through it while we're searching the house with our warrant.
Okay, that's fine. That's
all
fine.
Right. You're going to be detained in the car.
I don't understand why I need to be detained.
Because we can't have you letting other people on the property know what we're doing.
Listen, if I don't get this blood out of this lederhosen, quick, it's going to set in.
Do you have prestidigitation?
I don't have precedent. I don't have any magic. What are you kidding?
I mean,
what I have is a soiled uniform, and she makes us buy these.
I got
ourselves.
Inflict wounds, though. Will you shut up?
Fine. Okay. Can say this.
We're keeping you here for our own safety.
Okay. Fine.
All right. Get in the car. Hands behind your back.
Can you leave the windows rolled down?
Yeah, no. I can.
We'll crack them.
Yeah.
My car, my rules.
I tear off a piece of tissue and shove it up his nose after I put his hands behind his back and cuff
him. Thanks. Okay. All right. Fine. Go ahead. Go on. Go on in.
All right.
And I push a little button on the corner. Basically, goes, boop, boop.
And I lock the gate after we go through.
So are you going to drive the car on down into the house or just walk it in?
Drive it to the house.
Okay. All right.
Yeah. Well, I don't know. We might try to go in quiet. This is a raid, guys.
Oh, yeah. We should keep it here, I guess.
Yeah.
But we could get to the front door real fast.
All right. Let's go.
All right. Yeah.
Just squeeze him aside. You're going to sit on his lap.
The gate is locked behind us.
Okay.
Hey, right. How far away am I from them?
You said you went down further.
Yeah.
100 yards. You could barely see that them driving so by.
Are we going to go in there?
From where you are in the little woods. The wooded area.
Bust right in. One through the back door, one through the front. Or both through the front door, I guess.
Oh, it's a range. Just like Daddy likes it.
Yeah.
Oh, but I can still see them. Can I still see them? Mm-hmm. I got eyes on them? All right, so I'm going to telepathically say this to Woods. I'm a pig, man.
Wee! Wee!
I'm a pig. Wee! I'm a pig, dude. I'm a pig.
Wee!
Oh, this means okay. I'm gonna head over to him.
Pig calling. Yeah, I did. I won a pig calling competition in my younger days.
Hey, I'm gonna go free these pigs, man. I'm gonna create a distraction.
We're driving up to the house real fast, right. Real
yeah,
hot.
That's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna go free these pigs.
Yeah, guns blazing.
Y'all see him break through the wooded area. He's like trotting alongside the car for a bit, looking at y'all as y'all have this conversation.
That kid's crazy, but I like his ideas.
I wave a pig hoof. I wave a hoof at him. I'm a pig.
And then he peels off.
Okay, so I'm looking at the house. What do I see? Perception check.
So there's a next to the house is a little carnival. There's a Ferris wheel. There's a carousel with pigs. There's a little pond. There's flowers everywhere. The house, big beautiful house. You see two dwarves in lederhosen on the front porch, strolling back and forth. And
so we're not in combat anymore.
No. No.
And then, yeah, those dwarves, they're strolling across the deck. And just, yeah, it seems like they're in the middle of an argument of sorts.
Are we just going to, you want to just run up?
I feel like we should, like, run up on them. One of us should watch them while the other watches the house or something, or tie them up and then go search the house.
All right.
Show the arrest warrant.
Do you want me to slide in all fancy-like?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm going to try to slide in all fancy-like in front of their house. Like?
Like we're going over the hills on the road up to the house, yeah. Like, real fast. And
yeah. I want to see if I can slide it perfectly, like, and, like, whenever we turn, like, we show our badges.
Yeah.
Okay, well, give me a driving check, that old sleight of hand.
That's an 11? Yeah, that's an 11. I could try luck.
It's up to you.
Go for it.
No, don't. Yeah.
You only get three of those a day.
18.
Okay, yeah. You do that little slide maneuver, and his passenger door pops open, and Sprot just... He bounces right out of the car, like, before it's even stopped moving.
Well, he's got to roll for that.
With that badge out. Yeah, do roll for that. What is it?
I got a, what is it? Acrobatics?
Yeah.
That'd be an 8.
Okay, so you step out of the car, stumble a little bit, and you're fumbling for your wallet trying to get it out.
Yeah.
And the two guys in lederhosen orient on y'all, and they go, can we help you?
Yeah, yeah.
Why don't you roll for your grand entrance?
Oh, for the performance part?
Mm-hmm.
Sliding over the hood of the car?
Well...
I pull out the
warrant.
Can I
just use a perception check?
You're the one who said you wanted a grand entrance.
I didn't say I was going to step out of the car.
You wanted to flash the badges. You wanted to flash the badges.
Okay, it's for flashing my badge. I got a 3.
Yeah, you throw it into the mud. It flies out of your hand and falls in the mud. That's what happens. And there's one guy on the porch, and the other one's approaching the car, and he goes, "Can we help you, sirs?"
Yeah, we've got a warrant. We're going to need you to stay here outside the house while we go inside and search.
A warrant for what? For what?
Read it. Can you read?
Yeah, I can read.
Doesn't
like,
matter.
Here,
I pushed right past him.
Did some pigs rob a bank? I don't understand
what's
going on here.
Put your hands behind your back. Okay. You're being detained.
Okay. I'm being detained now. That's great.
Yeah. All
That's
right.
Great.
Yeah. All right.
Yeah.
Stop resisting. Is that guy resisting?
I'm not resisting.
I don't think he's resisting yet.
I'm just
saying.
Are
you resisting?
Yeah. No, I'm just
saying. Wait, are you resisting?
No, I'm just saying.
All right, get him.
There hasn't been
I'll punch him in the face. Hey, wait, are you trying to arrest him?
Yeah.
So that means I get a sneak attack on him.
Sure, that's fine.
Okay. So I got a what is a punch? It's just I got a 5 to hit. That didn't even pass his AC.
No, you completely swing wide.
Okay, good.
And he goes, whoa,
wait,
trying
do
to
I
hit people now.
A sneak attack?
Okay, fine, man. Fine. You know what? Fine. I don't think I need to be in handcuffs though. Why don't I just have a seat?
All right, have a seat.
Sit
on your hands.
Is that Earl in the back of the car? Why is his nose bleeding? What are you guys doing over here?
Hey, just sit down. Sit on your, like, come on.
Jeez.
Make this easy on us.
I don't get paid enough for this.
You want to sit here with him? Or do you want me to go in?
I'll go in. You sit here with the.
Okay. All
right. And
what are you looking for?
Not, like, paperwork.
Okay.
Yeah. I don't know.
That's the last time you did an investigation.
Chamber.
Listen, the missus has nothing to hide. I can take you straight to her paperwork.
All right.
Take you to our desk where she does all the work. All
right.
No, let's take him inside.
All right, let's take him inside. Yeah.
Okay, back to the adventures of Woods the pig.
I'm assuming I reached the pen right now, right?
It's a mile away.
It's a mile away?
Yeah, so you're trotting down the main road.
I mean, I'm a pig. I got some movement on me, too, so...
Pigs are fast.
Pigs have a baseline 40. See that?
40?
Baseline 40.
Hmm. Okay. So, yeah, you can see that you're coming up to the ranch. And you pass by three more
guard pigs.
Yeah, the boars with the goggles and the and the and as you're getting closer, you let's see, you hear and some of us ping eye. And you see a guy just start running towards you with a lasso in hand.
Mm-mm. I'm running away. I'm dodging that guy. I'm free.
Ain't no guy get back in the pen now, little piggy. Come on now.
Hoofing it.
And you hear a whip crack behind you. He's trying to catch up. He's trying desperately.
I mean,
roll to get away. Give me athletics.
Is he on foot?
Yeah.
He ain't running faster than me. I'm a pig.
He's a natural sprinter. You got 10 foot of movement speed more than him, and he rolled really well to be on your ass.
What is this check?
Athletics.
I got a 6.
Man. Yeah, you're not used to this pig body. You're having a little trouble catching up to this. So he starts catching up to your heels. And
the other pigs around?
Yeah, they're around too.
They're around?
Yeah.
I'm going to be like, help me out. Help me out, dudes.
Can you talk to them yet? Did you finish your ritual?
No, I'm using speech of beast and leaf, where I can kind of communicate with them subtly. I'm communicating with them emotionally.
Okay.
And I've got like fear, so I'm like being like, "Yo, help, brothers!
So
brothers,
these,
help me out!" And I'm just like,
"These
look,
three,
I look
these,
real scared."
You see those three pigs?
I look real scared.
Form up around you in like a corralling situation.
I don't feel safe here.
And they corner you in front of that man, and he pulls out a lasso. And throws it at you, and it lands in the mud next to you. You got one move. What are you going to do?
I'm going to go between his legs. I'm going to run off between his legs.
Give me another athletics check.
Come on, baby. 11.
Hot damn. You squeeze right between his legs, and he grabs for you and just barely misses, and you're running out behind him, and where do you go?
I'm going towards the pen.
Okay, so you've arrived at the pen. It's you know, it's wood slats and everything.
It's wood slats.
It's a big circular thing. There's a big overhead thing. You know when you go out to the fair and there's the fairgrounds area?
The pen? Yeah.
And there's like a giant overhead.
Yeah.
It's massive. It's like that.
I'm going to do a perception check real quick while I'm running to see if I can spot a weak spot in the fence.
Okay.
No, I don't.
Okay, so we'll move back to you two gentlemen. You've now entered the house. It's very German style on the inside. A lot of cream colored wallpaper with wood bracketing and all that kind of thing.
Okay.
High ceilings, and
I'm assuming that the house has been here for a long time because it's an old wealthy family in this area. I'm gonna roll for history. And see if I remember any like newspaper articles about when they built it or about, you know, because those are the houses of the rich and famous. There's all the glamour mags and stuff like that. Maybe somebody did a coverage over it.
Okay.
And maybe I picked up on some info.
I'm going to use my history as well.
That's a 20.
I got a 19 to help.
You've both heard of the Swainsons before. Yeah, this port conglomerate has been around for 150 years. Yeah, they came there and bought land when it was cheap, and brought over a lot of animals and got their fingers in the pork jar early, and they've been around, yeah, like I said, about 150 years.
But I don't remember any layout of the house or anything like that.
Oh, in that November issue of Cottage and Hogs, I remember they had the picture of
their cellar.
He
would definitely get, like, I was reading it on the show.
Yeah, they have a renowned cheese cellar.
Yeah. Yeah,
but it's private. They don't sell that. Mm. Yeah.
All right. Let's go to the office first, and then you keep them out there, and I'm gonna go inside.
Okay.
He's like, yeah, it's in there. It's where she keeps all of her papers.
Yeah, I got these ingrates.
All right.
She refuses to write with anything other than a quill. I don't know why.
I use I make sure the door is shut behind me, and then I use Chime of Opening in her office.
Okay. Okay, so there is a 10-foot tall jewelry box that pops open. That's the one thing you see, and that's what you're aiming at.
Okay.
And it pops right open.
All right.
And inside is a large collection of jewelry, a lot of pearl necklaces. It's like primarily pearl everything, pearl earrings, pearl necklaces, pearl bracelets, a few rings as well.
All right. Is there anything that like has like symbols on it or anything that like would let me know anything about her history or something? Or secret society symbols or anything?
Nothing looks, you know, weird.
All right, then I'm going to try to find the smallest piece of jewelry in the box, that like something that won't be noticed. Like,
really?
Yeah.
I'm surprised. There are a few ivory pigs in here.
Okay. I'm gonna leave the pigs. And then I'm gonna come out and be like, "Well, I'm gonna look through the desk first, see if I see anything suspicious." I got a 15 to investigation.
Okay, you got pork ledgers, you got IOUs, you've got a calendar of to do shite.
Oh, that's actually a 17. Sorry.
Okay. Nothing looks completely out of the ordinary.
All right.
At this point.
All right. And then I guess I'm going to come out, shut the door behind me. Well, make sure everything is in its right place.
Okay.
Like the jewelry box included.
Sleight of hand check.
It's 14.
Okay.
And then I'm going to leave the room and be like, "Well, I didn't see anything suspicious in there. Let's go to that cellar."
I was thinking the same thing.
All right.
Back to Mr. Pig. They're hot on your tail. You looked for a break in the fence.
I need some chase music instead of something chase music. I retain all my intellectual capacities when I'm doing this, and I know that the weakest point between a fence is right in the middle of the post. Real simple. And I'm going to take off. I'm going to charge. I'm going to do a charge attack as a boar got tusks. And I'm just going to run right in the center, and I'm going to bust through it.
Okay, go for it.
And my attack plus 3 with a pig, so I got a 17.
Yeah, you smash through that fence. And you hear behind you, "Oh, why didn't you do that in the first place? Oh, come on now. That's stupid. Man, God.
I smashed through it.
You could have gone through the gate."
I'm a run in a circle.
Now?
I'm going to start prancing like I'm somebody. Like I'm the head pig in charge, and I'm in here, and I'm looking around. I'm trying to put off an air that I'm like a leader pig, someone that they can really rally around. And then I find a couple bales of hay, and I climb to the top of that, and I let out the loudest oink I can in order to rally and just get pigs behind me. And I jump off into an endless sea of pigs and head right back out that door.
Weird thing. There aren't any pigs in this pen.
Oh, well. Oh. Well, then I enter in that pen, and
that was a great. That was
and
a
I'm
momentous.
Real surprised.
Yeah, that was, yeah,
yeah. So no pigs in here.
No,
but you said it's like a fair.
Yeah,
it's
like so
that
like
big.
There are places you haven't been yet. You're in what looks like the largest pen.
Okay,
but it's empty, and you don't really hear pig noises.
I'm a boar. I got excellent smell. I can smell truffles. I'm going to use perception and smell to see if I can smell livestock around at all. Okay. Or if livestock has even been in this pen in a long time. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
It was a three.
Do you have keen smell? Is that what that is?
No, it doesn't have it on this card. Oh. Or I would have advantage if I did.
Yeah.
It doesn't say keen smell, though.
I mean, the one thing you can tell is that definitely this pen had pigs in it very recently.
Very recently, but yeah. I can't. Okay, I'm just going to... Weird.
And then you do hear some pig noises. You do hear some slight pig noises.
I'm gonna go towards where I hear the pig noises.
Okay. So you wander across the open pen.
Yeah.
And you're the only pig in there. And you're looking through, like, basically like chicken wire. And you see a couple of pens away. And some smaller pens are some mama pigs and some piglets.
Okay.
But all the hogs, all the main pigs, all the main livestock, you don't see it.
I don't see them, man. I'm gonna try to bust those. I'm gonna bust those mama and baby pigs out.
Are you?
Yeah, I'm trying to bust them out.
You do see, in a pen adjacent to the mama and baby pigs, you see two dwarves playing a game of cards.
Wait, you said it's like chicken wire, right?
Yeah. Yeah. There are two dwarves in an adjacent pen, and they have battle axes strapped to their backs. And they're in heavy chainmail, and they're playing cards at a wooden table.
Okay, I'm just running as fast as I can. I'm gonna tear the chicken wire up with my tusks.
And give me a go for it.
14.
Okay, so you tear through there, and you hear the mama squealing, and the little piglets are running around frightened.
Okay.
And what do you back out?
These other guys are next door.
Yeah, they see this happen.
They
look over.
I'm gonna squill them and then run away.
And they look and then they look over. They see the hole in the fence. They see you run away, and they just go right back to playing cards.
Okay, well I'm running towards the house.
And then you hear, "Hey, come back here, pig! Now you done broke another fence." He goes, "This guy's gone wild." And you hear the guys at the table go, "Not our problem. Not why we're here." And you run off back towards
run off towards the house.
Okay. Okay. Good job. Causing utter chaos.
Can I get away from their sight?
Yeah, because the one guy's concerned. You just smashed up the fence. He's got to fix it. One guy's got work to do. The other two dudes weren't concerned at all.
Okay.
And you trot on down that mile back to the house.
Okay. Yeah, that's what I'm doing.
Cool. What are you fellas up to?
Going to the cheese cellar.
Okay. And you get down there, and it's dark, and it's dank, and you hear a dripping sound, and you smell just like the stankiest foot odor you've ever smelled in your life. And there's a bit of an echo in here.
That's some dramatic cheese.
Oh, Jesus.
It's a big cheese cellar. And as you're creaking down the stairs, you hear, "Oh, who's in here?"
Sorry, we're here serving a warrant.
A warrant? You can't have my cheese.
Whose cheese?
It's I'm sorry. You can't have the Mrs. Cheese. This is my cheese. I'm working a little hard on this cheese.
Sir, sir, calm down. Nobody wants your cheese.
Oh, well, I'll be the judge of that. Let me eat the warrant.
We're just here looking for information.
What do you want to know?
Are there any secret compartments down here or passageways? We have a warrant. Remember?
I want to just check out the room.
You want to see my secret of cheeses?
Not the secret cheeses. We want to see if there's any nefarious activities going on here.
Oh, mamma mia.
Sir, we're going to have to detain you. For our own safety.
No, I have to take care of the cheese.
No, the cheese will be fine for just like, it'll only be a few minutes. It won't be that long.
Okay. Well, watch your step and don't eat my cheese.
Okay. Yeah, we
work real hard on the cheese.
Yeah, we're not going to eat your cheese.
Shouldn't. I'm lactose intolerant, so this is going to be a bad time for me. So, I'm going in there. I'm assuming I'm looking at a wall of like round cheeses.
Yep, and there are a few. There's like a sort of like a crisscross passageways. Mm.
And there's a lot of big wheels of cheese.
Yep.
I just want to go around and like start thumping them.
Okay.
Just walking around. He's like, you know, like every cheese is like different. Like it has a.
Yeah.
Has a different density. Give me an
investigation check.
That's a 19.
The third
well,
one.
Well, with advantage because I'm touching it. So yeah, seven,
on the third one that you thump, you hear, "Oh, that's a bad cheese."
You know, sir, this is going to work out what really well like? For you in the end if you actually help us right now. You'll end up further along, like further ahead of anybody else involved in this.
For the
if
what?
You just help
I know
us out
you're
now.
A gamer. You just want the free of cheese.
I'm going to roll persuasion with that. That's a 20.
I pulled a bad cheese off the shelf.
This is my cheese. You cannot have my cheese. This is for us and us alone. Secret cheeses. I work hard. My family lived down here all 100 years.
Okay.
You cannot take my cheese.
I'm not here to take your cheese, sir.
Wait, sir, are you telling me that they don't let you leave the cellar?
The cheese.
Investigation if he's left the cellar. 19 plus.
He is pale as fuck.
Like 27, yeah.
He's wearing rags. He has no shoes on. His fingernails are like an inch and a half long.
And the do yeast you get infection. To eat anything? God. Sir, are you okay? Have you ever eaten
look
your
around.
Own cheese?
I have all I need. The cheese. The oh, drip of the water.
He's eaten nothing but cheese in his entire life.
Are you okay?
I feel fine. Little bit of a stomach ache, but it's
are
okay.
Are you here because you want to be, or are you here because you have to be?
I'm here for the cheese.
Okay.
Look,
all
if,
right.
we, if we raid, I've seen this before. If we raid this place, we need to make sure that he doesn't leave this environment, because to bring him into the real world would be a shock to his system.
Oh yeah.
We got to slowly introduce different kinds of food into him. So
I
he's
cannot leave
him
my cheese.
Little,
yeah. All right. I feel like we're wasting time here. Down here.
Anyway, all so right. I pulled the bad cheese, the one that went.
Oh yeah. That's for the pigs, the hogs. That's the bad cheese.
What did, how did it sound different? Did it sound hollow?
No, it's not the hollow. There's a cheese in there. It's just the bad cheese.
Well, let's bring it to the pigs.
Well, let's just pull it out and open it up and see what's in it.
All right.
So I bring it down, and I use my my rapier to kind of slice it like a... Like one of those paper slicers.
And you see him instantly pull out a handkerchief and put it over his nose. I need constitution checks from both of you.
12.
Okay.
14.
Okay, so you both, just this odor hits you that smells like the worst case of athlete's foot that you can imagine.
Ooh.
And it's pungent and it clings to your nostril hairs and it like just... wants to smother you, but you all both...
right, I'm out, and I go up the stairs.
Yeah, you both see him pull out his handkerchief, and you start to realize what's happening before it hits you entirely, and you both stop from puking, but it's bad.
Seth, I told you it's about a cheese. Let's get it out of here. Now you're broken open. It's disgusting. How can I have that cheese down here and ruin the other cheese?
I look for like a chute or something where they throw the refuse.
Oh, you're looking for the cheese shoot. It's over there.
I bring it there.
Like and this. It's actually a little catapult mechanism.
So, girl, pull it back and put the cheese up, and then you pull the trigger.
I pull the trigger.
And you... Boom, and you're listening, and you're listening, and then you hear...
That's the cheese. I hit the cheese.
Wow. Like, no wonder you have never leave this place. This is a lot of fun.
I'm going to be looking out the kitchen window while I wait for him.
Anyway, I grab him by his rags, and I shake him. I say, where's the secret door?
I don't
where's
know.
Where's the secret entrance?
I don't know. All I have is the cheese.
Just somebody comes down here and does nefarious shit. I can feel it.
I don't know what you're talking about. All we do down here is make the cheese and eat the cheese and sleep with the cheese and touch of the cheese.
I toss him and I like
smell
pull my sunglasses
of
off. Ah!
I just want to be with my cheese.
Okay, so you get back to the house.
yeah, you said there's a livestock area, a house, and an amusement park area, right?
Yep.
Is the amusement park in service today?
No.
Okay, so there's not a bunch of pigs at the amusement park, right?
Correct.
I know they're in the house, so I'm just going to stay a pig for a while, and I'm going to go towards the amusement park, and I'm going to investigate the amusement park.
Okay.
As a pig.
I love that it has pig noises in it.
I'm just going to go around and smell some things.
So do I.
You know? And I'm, you know, I'm kind of rooting around like I'm a pig. You know, in the ground, I'm trying to find stuff like fake rocks. You know, I'm trying to find stuff like weird amusement park entrances. You know, amusement parks are just filled with back hallways and security, just all kinds of logistical things. I'm trying to find me a way.
Okay,
to get
so
in there.
You see the pig carousel. Mm-hmm. You see a hot dog stand. You see...
I head right towards a hot dog stand.
Okay, okay,
that's what a pig would do.
It's enchanting. I head right towards that.
You smell bread inside that stand.
I'm getting that stand.
Okay, so you smash it open?
Yes, I smash it open.
Give me another roll for that. It's locked up.
Are you succumbing to your pig tendencies?
Oh, yeah. Right in there. Yeah. You smash right in there, and you can see the only thing they've stocked in here is bread, because this bread is good for a while. Okay. It's not open currently, so there's no like vegetables or meat in here.
Yeah.
But there is bread.
Okay, so I'm going to eat some of that bread. And then I'm gonna snap to and remember that I had stuff I was trying to do. This is really good bread. And then I want to look inside the stall and see if there's like a logistical hatch or something. I want to see if there's a way in to get in the service corridor.
There is not, but you do get one D4 temporary hit points.
Hell yeah, hell yeah.
From this bread that you found.
Temp.
Yeah.
Hell yeah, max temp hit points.
Nice job. There's a house of horrors that shows the process of
slaughtering pigs.
Yes. What else? Bumper pigs. There's bumper pigs. Well, you see that there's an arena for bumper pigs and a bunch of saddles that would be on pigs if pigs were in the arena. For the kids to ride pigs and smash pigs into each other.
Mutton busting. That's different. That's different, but same thing.
The sheep, like busting the sheep. Yeah. Mutton busting. I mean, I'm just trying to find some sort of logistical area, like some, you know, behind the curtain as you speak in all amusement parks. Where do the employees go? Where's a break room? Where's a security room?
It's just a bit of a ghost town today, possibly because Tilda's away.
Okay.
And you know nothing sticks out of the ordinary.
Nothing sticks out of the ordinary.
Nope.
Well,
let me leave the room for a second.
Yeah.
Let y'all have a discussion. Because y'all have seen some things maybe y'all need to talk about.
You going to take a break?
Yeah.
Yeah, take a break.
We'll take a
time for it. Yeah. Yeah. Okay. We'll
take a break. That sounds like a long Sunday drive.
Yeah.
And we're back.
Yeah. So, man, that was some damn fine bread.
Yeah. You pigging out on that bread meant for the kids.
Literally.
But now that I feel satisfied, I'm going to go find my friends in the house.
Okay.
Find my colleagues.
So I assume that you run up the front porch?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I just go right in.
And as you run by, you hear, hey, where did you come from? Get back in the... Oh, God, I want to catch that pig so bad. They're probably going to hit me in the face if I try.
Hey, are you supposed to do your job? We got it over here. We'll deal with this guy.
What?
Yeah, go get the pig.
Oh, okay. You let me. I can go wrangle that pig.
Yeah, go ahead.
Sweet. Okay, and he runs out.
Wait, what are we? Who are we talking to?
Runs out the front.
I don't
Aaron,
know.
Yeah, see, who are you? Are you talking to?
Aaron, you see the front door?
Are we out front?
No, one of those two guys at the house guards.
Yeah, Aaron, you see the front door bust open, and a dwarf comes running out in lederhosen, and squares up on you, and dives at you.
Aren't y'all together?
Yeah.
In the house?
This is an attempted grapple check.
I thought that was
if you're in the house.
Outside. I thought that was the guard that we had.
The guy, yeah.
They came with us.
The guy that y'all were with saw...
Wait, no, I'm just trying to find them. So if they're
I
on
know.
The,
he oh. saw you through the window out in the front yard.
Oh, okay. All
right. And they were like, yeah, go catch that pig. So he dives at you to try and grapple you. Give me an opposed grapple check.
Okay. It's a nine. Grapple's a strength. It's a 10.
Okay. He hits the mud next to you. What do you do?
I'm just trying to find them. I'm trying to get away.
Okay, you're going to run in the house?
Yeah, I'm cheesing it.
All right, so you run in the house?
Yeah, run in the house.
He goes, get back here, pig!
And you guys see a pig come running in through the front door and just tracking mud all over the house.
What the fuck?
Just running through the house.
And I sit down and wave my piggy hand.
Oh.
Oh, hey, piggy.
Hey, yeah.
Little piggy?
And I'm going to tell one of them to close the door. Hey, just close the door.
All right.
Close the door.
You're speaking to them telepathically.
Mm-hmm. Telepathically, yeah.
But then they're speaking to you.
They have to talk to me.
I'm not speaking to them.
It's
there's another guard already here.
It's a one-way link. One-way link.
I said, hey, piggy, and then I just went up and locked the door.
Yeah.
That's the cool thing. Now that y'all are in the same room,
you
can actually have a conversation.
I have to be able to see them.
Yeah.
Yeah, for that to work. I'm just going to sit down. Hey, sorry about the way I smell. There's a lot of stuff going on here. Did you guys find anything cool in the house?
No,
nothing.
No, I just shake my head. I don't talk.
You can talk if you want to.
I don't, because there's the other guard here.
Ah.
I can
only talk to one of you at the same time, so I'm going to tell you, and then you tell him what I'm saying, and then we're all going to be on the same page. All
right.
There's no livestock here. This whole thing's a front. There's no livestock.
I got a feeling this is the only pig that we'll see today.
No, there's some pigs, but they're like watch boars. They're watch boars. So, but there was something suspicious. There's all kinds. Look, there's like people that are chasing me, and they have watch boars, and then I ran across some fellers that were playing cards, and they paid me no mind, and that was in a livestock pen that had no livestock. So,
and then the door slams open, and he goes, "There's that pig, grab him, help me, guys."
Hey,
we gotta get him back in the pen.
I accidentally throw some oil on him.
Keep him off me.
On who?
Oh,
him.
You're gonna grease me up.
Yeah.
He's okay. What are you doing? What is that there? Is that like knockout juice?
It was my beverage, and I accidentally spilled it.
It's weird.
You do have that bag of lube.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
I'm gonna get you. All right.
I open up the back door. So then I go outside.
Y'all get him. You gotta help your buddy.
Hey, y'all are in a fancy dining room.
I'm gonna yell for him. Just follow me. Follow me. And I'm gonna run out.
He dives at you at disadvantage.
I yell, "Get that pig!"
Give me an opposed check. Okay. Yeah, he dives at you and just slips off your backside and slams into the dining room table. And you hear like cutlery flying and dishes breaking. And he goes, "Oh God, she's gonna kill me for that." Oh, we gotta get that pig.
I'm gonna slam into as much shit on my way out as I can.
And I sent him. What did he say to you?
So he said that there's only one place where the guards were that nothing else was, and that's the pig pens where there were no pigs.
It's a shell corporation.
Yeah, we gotta go there.
All right.
So let's follow that
pig. Yeah. Let's get that pig. Come on, guys.
Okay. Yeah. We're gonna get him. And they start running.
Yeah.
And
I as we're running behind them, I'm gonna be behind them, like kind of eyeballing like some way to trip these guys up.
Okay.
I'll
tell you this: when you exit the back door and you see him running off and them chasing him, give me a perception check, you two.
Nat 20.
Damn.
Okay. You spot the wheel of cheese that you shot from the catapult earlier out in the middle grounds where they're running towards.
Okay. Yeah. All right.
Just,
I've smelled so many things today, none of them pleasant. This is quite a day. But we got to get that pig. All right, let's follow him.
We need chase music. This is a chase now.
Yeah.
So he's running. Give me a roll. Give me an athletics check to run from these two guys. These two dwarves.
You want me? What am I doing?
You're running from these dwarves.
I'm running from them.
They want to catch you while you're greased up.
Okay. I got a 6.
Okay.
Do I get advantage because I'm greased?
No, this is just athletics.
Oh, it's just athletics.
It's pure athletics.
Okay.
And one of them catches up to you and dives at you. Give me an opposed grapple check.
16.
Oh, yeah. He just hits the ground
17,
next to you.
Sorry.
He's 17. Scrambling up. He's like, "We gotta get that pig! We can't have loose pigs on this farm!"
Nope.
And they get up and they start running after you again. What are you guys doing?
Chasing them.
Okay.
I'm strategically taking these guys out. So while we're running behind them, I'm going to like kick one guy's legs out from under him.
I'll give you advantage on that.
11. 18. What is that? That's like a shove, right?
Yeah, no, you get him.
Okay. And he's down.
He goes face down in the stinky cheese you threw out earlier.
Uh-huh.
And comes up with a nostril full of cheese and just starts throwing up.
Oh, God. Oh, that's gross, fella. And it's saying to you.
Yeah, no, I go.
Bad cheese.
I start running, well, not running, but like sneakily going off towards the pig pens.
Okay. All right. So y'all are following the grease pig and running off towards the pens. And there's still one guy in Lederhosen, muddy Lederhosen, following y'all. And he's like, guys, why aren't y'all helping me? I feel like you're not helping me catch this damn pig. We got to catch this pig. We got to put him up in a pen. Why is that so hard? Why
aren't
you helping me?
I'm not there. I'm going away.
He's saying this to Zach as you sprint off. He's like, that guy's going after the pig. What are you doing?
I think I'm going to detain you.
Well, you told me to catch the pig. I'm doing my job.
Why is the pig so important?
No.
That's like the only pig I've seen this entire day.
There are no pigs allowed outside of the pens other than the guard pigs. Them's the rules. Okay?
Okay, well, let's go. Let's go get him. Is this guy just going to sit here?
Who? I think he's sick. I don't know. But I got to catch that pig. I got to do my job. I don't need to worry about him. I don't need to worry about you. I need to worry about catching that pig.
All right, well, let's go catch the pig. Come on.
All right, let's go. See, I'll run off. And where's Grease Pig going?
I'm headed right back towards, remember the mama and the baby pigs?
Yeah, inside, so you go through the hole you made earlier.
I go through the hole, right through the hole. And I'm going to eye the two guys that were playing cards. And I'm going to run right up under their card table and jump and fuck their card game all up. And I'm going to run the
And run as
off.
Soon as I hear that, I'm going to say, get that pig! I yell that real loud and comes running up after them, like past
I'm
their
I'm
going to
slide
game.
On through and just, okay. I'm going to take well, that card game out.
So whenever I see him hit that table, like I'm assuming the guy got up ahead of me, I'm going to, if there's an entrance, and I think there's out sheds around the shed.
Yep.
I'm going to duck around it.
Try to hide?
And hide in the shadow.
Stealth check.
Yeah. 11.
And you see the guy come running by and he stops and goes, what the hell are you doing? What the hell are you? You're a smoker, aren't you?
Oh, yeah. Long time.
Yep. God, I gotta get that pig. And he runs off. Now, you see those guys stand up and you're like, you gotta catch that pig.
Yeah, and I run past them after the pig.
And you see them looking down and go, ah, well, the game's ruined. Oh, well. We'll set up another one.
Damn it.
And then one of them stands back up and goes, wait a minute. Who the hell was that?
I start snooping around the corner. I totally hook it.
The fellow in Lederhosen that was following the pig is running by those two guys and they go, hey, Carl, hey, stop, what are you doing? There's a loose pig I gotta catch. Yeah, no, who are those guys? They have a warrant. They're cops. They're here to search the premises. Oh, are they? Yeah. It's cool though. I mean, you know, it's they saw the cheese seller, the you know, her room where she writes. It's fine. I got to catch this pig. And he's like, okay, all right, fine. And you, as the pig, are off. You hear this as you're running out of earshot.
Uh huh.
That's the last thing.
Yeah.
You hear.
All right, and I jump behind stuff.
You want to stealth check?
Yeah, stealth check that. Yeah. I think my stealth is a plus one.
And you, Mr. Pig, give me a stealth check. See if you can finally escape.
I got an 8.
Okay.
I just like ran to another part of the pen,
mm-hmm.
And I kind of like noticed that I'm just a little too fast for everyone.
Yep.
And upon realizing that the guys who game I screwed up aren't chasing me, I'm disinterested in the entire. I unwild shape.
I pull out my gun.
And I just, I'm like, because that was like the last ditch thing was like, I'm trying to get these guys to chase after me. And when they don't, and I turn around and see there's nobody chasing me, I'm just like, all right, well, I turn right back in my form.
Okay.
Actually,
and I head back towards those guys.
All right.
I pull out my crossbow, actually, in my place of cover. Because I heard them.
We got some hay bales.
It sounds like the theme music to a farming game.
Yeah, it does.
It's like a local car dealer who's trying to sell trucks.
Yeah.
Come on down, the sales be gonna get your money for a car.
What's also funny is that it's the exact chord progression of Blue on Black.
Yeah. Well, they're all ripoffs.
It's just a 4-chord progression, but with the intonation of the instruments, it's very Blue on Black. We need to get some new markers.
Yep.
We need some like neon chalk markers so we can actually see it.
Yeah, for sure.
Everybody got silent on the video table, huh?
Yeah.
Can be done.
I don't know how it's gonna look on camera, but yeah. Hold on, I gotta use bathroom real quick.
Yeah, true.
We just use pogs.
Hey, while you're out there, can you grab the yellow beer in the door? Yeah. Yeah.
And you could put like your
bevel out the middle of it.
And like a little sensor right there.
Yeah.
And then whenever you set it down, it would move your pog there.
That would be dope.
I think they have something like that. But it's like. And you have to cook.
Where am I?
Where you are.
I specifically tried to dive behind cover between me and them.
That's cover.
Okay.
Yeah, that's. Yeah, you're out by a little shed filled with grain.
Thank you.
Wait, are we rolling for initiative?
Well, we're not.
You're readying for combat. Okay.
Yeah, we're not in initiative yet. Thank God.
We're about to be. As soon as David says it.
Yeah, that depends on what you do. Okay. You jokesters.
Wait.
It was rain. There's no longer a Dextar Woods in pig form. You've all chosen to stop running around like idiots. On the pig farm.
Never!
And you have all attempted to hide, albeit very poorly.
I hid in plain sight.
And you hear these guys setting their game back up.
So these are the guys right here?
Mm-hmm.
And are these walls that you've drawn out? Or
pig pens.
Pig pens.
Most of it see-through. Anything that is a square is actually a sort of shed. Behind which you consider yourself covered.
Okay, so this is all pig pens. Those mm-hmm. are the guys with their card table. And mm-hmm. then I'm guessing this is an area we don't know.
This is the open, giant open pig pen.
Okay.
Oh, how are we past?
This is the one you broke through and yeah. ran through.
Oh, okay.
And then came to the other
okay,
area.
All right.
So wait. This over here is inside the shit.
Yeah. It's all under the big awning.
Oh, it's like at the fair.
Yes.
They're all pens.
Yes.
Okay.
So we have like clear line of sight on them.
Yes.
Oh, okay.
So I'm hidden next behind a shed next to a pen.
Cool. I'm gonna since I can see these guys, I'm gonna I see that Shields is closest. I'm gonna telepathically talk to him real quick and be like, hey, don't respond to me. Okay? I mean your brain, don't fucking say anything.
A mouth, yeah.
I'm going to make a sign for you guys to run in at the same time. I'm going to do something.
Can you see me?
He said it. I can see you. He said it.
I'm just.
Fine. I'm gonna turn to him. Hey man. Hey, be ready. Be ready. All right. Look.
I hold my crossbow just be up ready. A little bit.
I'm gonna cast spike growth right in the center of this.
Okay. Tell me about spike growth.
The ground in a 20-foot radius centered on a point within range twists and sprouts hard spikes and thorns. The area becomes difficult terrain for the duration, which is 10 minutes. When a creature moves in or within the area, it takes 2d4 piercing damage for every 5 feet it travels. The transformation of the ground is camouflaged. It makes it difficult terrain, too. So if you know the difficult terrain rules for them to move... Right?
Yeah, half movement.
Half movement. So I'm going to cast it on them.
Draw it.
20 foot?
Mm-hmm. Draw where you cast it. What's the range on that from where you are? Is it 30 or 60 foot?
It's 150 feet.
Nice. Yeah, you know, you have plenty of room to work with.
Cast it on the middle of the table.
It's right there. So leading up to it, isn't it? But that whole room and whatever else is around. So it's right there. Guy's in deep. That guy's not in deep. But I cast it and I talk to him. I'm like, hey, draw your guns on. Tell him not to move.
Yeah. Don't move. We've got you surrounded.
And then in that, I'm behind them. I'm going to be like, don't move. We got you corralled up in here.
I roll a persuasion check.
I'm gonna roll intimidation.
9. Never mind.
Yeah, that's not very intimidating, but.
I said don't move! Intimidation roll. Even less.
And you hear.
I said don't move!
You hear. We're just playing cards here. I don't know what y'all are doing here.
What are you guarding here?
Nothing. The property.
Just tell me, like, why are there armed guards in an empty pig pen, but everywhere else, there are unarmed guards in lederhosen?
Well, these are prize pigs. The mama pigs over here and these piglets, they're the big money makers, see?
All right, I go towards to one of the piglets.
Okay, they are in this pen over here.
Okay. I, like, just move over here with my crossbow trained at one of the piglets now. Is this what you're protecting?
Hey, cut Jesus that. Hey, stop. Hey, Christ. Cut that out.
He goes,
cut
that out. Those are our prized pigs.
Hey, so is there a wall here?
It's pens. It's like
it's like waist
horizontal
high.
Bars. Yeah. Like nothing that can actually conceal.
Like half fences, pins.
The only things that can conceal you are the smaller squares.
So how near am I to the nearest like pig pen?
Yeah, I mean you're in one technically.
Okay, so I'm gonna look down and I'm gonna kick my foot around and look in the dirt and the muck and see if I spot anything fishy. And that's a 16.
Okay. Not really. I mean, you know, just some old hay and some muck down at the bottom. A few droppings.
Oh, yeah. I'm going to use my sending stone to talk to Cece and say oink, oink.
We haven't found anything yet.
Yeah, we haven't found anything.
Oh, no?
No. I rolled an 18 on insight for their behavior.
I mean, it's too late. He did it.
God damn.
Oh, he did it. So that's interesting.
What'd you find when you kicked the dirt?
Nothing.
You're the detective!
All right, I hear him say oink oink, and I'm like, oh shit, okay, now we gotta actually search this place. And I go into.
I mean,
like,
one of y'all can cancel.
Yeah, I say, oink oink, no, no.
I'm going to say on my false alarm. Okay. False alarm. False alarm.
Okay. Okay. Okay.
And I'm going to move. I'm going to move up. Move up to a clear line of sight with that guy.
They go, you guys are wasting your time here. I don't know what you're looking for. I don't know what you're.
I rolled an 18 on insight on them.
The guy who's talking seems like he's full of shit.
Yeah.
He's a bad liar.
All right. So what's actually going on here?
I'm going to look over those pigs and say, hey, those aren't prize pigs at all.
I point the crossbow back at him.
Those are not prize pigs at all. That's some very mediocre pigs.
And I walk towards him with my crossbow trained on him.
Okay. Okay, it's a nat 20. So I'm going to tell y'all what happens right now.
I got my hand on the. I got my hand on my piece.
Old Orangey there grabs the table and goes, hey, flip. And he goes, yeah. And he goes, catch. And he tosses the table to him, and he immediately rolls that table on its side and stuffs it in the mud.
Does he move?
No, none of them. They don't have to move. They move their arms to do this. And he creates a wall of that table between the two of you. And with their nat 20, you see both of them immediately peek around the side of that wall.
Do they move?
No.
How are they peeking around the side of the wall if they're not moving?
Because the table's not wider than their range of being able to fire. And they fire crossbow bolts.
So it's flipped?
Yeah. Draw a line.
It's
draw a 10-foot line straight across from that dwarf this way.
So he flipped it like over here.
Yeah.
So it's like it went. Psh. So from, like
yeah, right there.
10-foot like
yeah, straight across. Like that. Boom.
Is that what you wanted?
Yeah. So the guy with the orange mohawk gets a shot off at. Sprot, what's your AC?
19.
Well,
of course it is, Paladin.
He's not going to hit that. And Woods, you see the guy lean out and take a crossbow bolt shot at you, which misses.
Okay.
And now we do initiative.
Wait, if they don't see me, do I have to roll initiative? Oh, yeah, I guess so.
Yeah.
I got a 15.
God damn, I got a 3.
6.
Okay, so...
15.
I got 3.
All right, Sprite, you get first go.
All right.
Don't go in that patch.
I'm not. I'm gonna shoot the orange guy. Does a 10 hit? No, wait, that's a 13.
Mm-hmm. Negative.
All right. And then I'm going to... gonna get on the other side of that table.
Okay.
And duck down.
Smart move. Cool. Now it's their turn.
Like, bracing myself up against it so it can't, like... Yeah.
Okay. Okay, so Flip, the guy on the upper right, is going to leave that threatened space. He'll take damage just from moving the 5 feet, right?
Yeah, the one behind the table?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah.
Just from moving the 5 feet, he'll still take damage, right?
He's going to take damage, yeah, every time they move their space.
Yeah.
So he's moving out of my threatened space, so...
You're behind a table.
Yeah, so, every square is damage.
So he'll there's only one square he's going to be moving through.
Okay.
So he'll take that damage. What is it?
2d4.
Oh, shit.
It's
2.
2 damage.
2 damage.
And he runs right up to you. What's your AC?
Mine?
Mm-hmm.
15.
Okay. This is bad for you.
Okay.
He pulls out a long sword and just hacks you twice across the chest. 17 points of damage as he just lays you open.
Wait, what was his path to get there? Because...
Just around the side of the table there.
Because if I'm right there,
and he's coming through here.
Yes, if you are right there.
And he moves right
and
there.
And not one square over where it kind of looked like where you
didn't
were.
Didn't you already get an opportunity to attack this room?
No, he didn't. You no, can I take didn't. It, though.
Oh, yeah. I had myself at the center of those four. Which
I thought so. Yeah, yeah, yeah. So you want to say you were closer, so you got an opportunity to attack.
Yes.
Take it.
All right.
I'll drive with that.
Does a 12 hit?
No.
Okay.
Okay. So he lays you up with that long sword.
He got me twice, right?
Yeah.
Okay. So these boys got they got multi attack, I guess.
They yeah. do. They do. So okay. this other fellow, Sprot, you hear, "Aah!" and he just starts charging. So he will take
this orange boy.
Yeah, he will take 64 damage.
He's moving three spaces.
Yeah, he's okay. gonna try and charge and break through the table.
Do you want
into
one,
into
just roll it twice. Sprot. Oh, okay. Yeah. I got it.
3, 7, 10.
Okay.
Roll that in again.
Oh, yeah, one more time. Because 6.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, 6. So 16.
16 total?
16 total.
Okay, and now he is going to attempt to break through that table. Ooh, no.
It's also move 3 spaces?
Yeah.
Okay, so that's like his entire movement.
Yes.
Yeah, yeah.
And he slams into that table.
Cool.
And Sprot, you feel it, but it doesn't flip over on top of you or smash open. Mm-hmm. But it definitely moves like a foot or two in the mud.
Yeah.
And it is Conan's turn.
So I'm going to use my sending stone to go to CC and go, oink. Oink.
God damn it.
They know there were cops and they attacked us.
Yeah, true.
And you hear back. Confirmation on the order for pork.
Oink.
Good luck, fellas. Okay, so. What else are you going
to
do?
Was that an action?
Yeah.
That was a full action?
Not a full action. It was an action. You have a bonus action movement.
I guess I'll cast Insightful Fighting. Or I'll use Insightful Fighting. They got to roll against me.
Yeah.
Was it Investigation or Perception? Insight.
I think it's Wisdom for them, isn't it?
I got a 26.
Okay, they fail. Jesus. So you mark somebody, but you can't really hit him this time.
Yeah, I'm gonna mark. I'm mark him, and probably the guy in the red, or whoever I can see. I guess is this.
Yeah, it's the fella currently chopping.
What's his name? Flip or Flop?
That's Flip.
Flip.
You haven't learned the other guy's name.
is it Toe?
Well, now toe I have to flip? Change it though.
Toe Flop.
Toe Flop. Is that what it is?
Yeah.
What the
Woods.
Fuck is it?
I love it.
It's me.
Yeah. Yeah.
A really good graffiti artist.
You've just had two longsword slashes across your chest. You are bleeding profusely. And he's looking at you like he is ready to go.
All right.
Time to break out the big guns. You gonna turn to a pig again?
Is it a plane? Is it a bird?
No. let me see here. I'm gonna turn. This is my bonus action. I'm gonna turn into a giant toad.
A giant toad. Okay.
And as my action, I'm gonna attack. What is it? Was that a 15? Plus 4, so it's a 19.
That's a hit.
And what I'm going to do with that attack is I'm going to do Swallow.
Mm-mm. Is there an opposed check?
Yes, there is. No, actually, there's not.
What? You just have to hit?
No. The toad makes a bite attack against the medium or smaller, which was my attack.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
If I make it, then I just swallow him.
Oh,
God. Swallow him whole. If the attack hits, the target is swallowed, and the grapple ends. The swallowed target is blinded and restrained,
and has total cover against any attacks and effects outside other than the toad. It takes 3d6 acid damage. Humane.
Roll it
at the start. Well, it's at the start of each toad's turn, so it's so it's gonna be on the next turn, I think. If that's rules is written, I would say it'd be on the next one, right? It just got in there. It's probably gonna take them the next one.
Let me look up restrained.
The toad can only have one target swallowed at a time. If I die, the swallowed creature is no longer restrained and it can escape. But there is no check. There's no.
No, that's fair. He has disadvantage to try and disembowel you.
Well, he doesn't even have that. He's restrained.
No, I've looked it up.
Oh,
restrained.
You looked it up? Oh, okay. Yeah.
Attack rolls against him have advantage.
Yeah.
But he's inside of you. So someone would have to climb.
The swallowed target is blinded and restrained.
Yeah.
And has total cover. Yeah.
Yeah. I don't think there's such a thing as. There's such thing as double disadvantage.
Yeah.
So he just has disadvantage.
Okay.
But he is blind. Cool. So you swallow
that's not,
him.
That's not my movement either. So
correct.
Yeah. So I'm doing. Yeah. So I got him there. yeah. And I'm just gonna hop.
Thank you, Chris.
Yeah.
He's in the belly of the beast.
I'm just gonna hop 20 feet over there.
Cool. Excellent. Is that?
I'm gonna let out a burp. A big toad burp.
Okay.
And when I let out the burp, I'm gonna blow it in his partner's face.
His partner goes, "Flop, no!"
That's another thing I did not want to smell today.
And Sprot, it's your turn.
All right. Is that guy leaning up over the thing at all?
Oh no, it's a big table.
Okay,
then big table.
You're
both covered.
Move right there and shoot him.
Hey, go man, you playing that new Pecan Brothers soundtrack? I like that.
It's the Pecan
Brothers. No, it's the Almond Brothers.
Damn it.
Oh, the Almond Brothers.
The Almond Brothers.
What in that one was it?
No, it wasn't. It was
that's
an
not
eight.
Their name.
Okay.
But,
I know, the Almond.
Yeah, the Almond Brothers.
I am going to use my Acid Breath weapon on him, though.
Go for it.
That is DC 11. Or Dex.
He makes it, so he'll take half damage.
Yeah. Two points of damage.
Okay. You vomit all over him.
Yeah.
Good job. And now, what else are you going to do?
I'm going to move.
I'm going to jump this fence thing.
Okay.
And come over here.
Give me a little athletics check to hop over.
Okay.
Eight.
You come down in thick mud and you let's see. You moved 5, 10. That's where you stay.
Okay.
That's where you stay.
Alright.
Yeah. And it is their turn. Aaron, from inside of you, you feel struggling. You feel
okay.
Struggling. Can they attempt to break out of you? Is that a thing?
It doesn't say. No, there's no. The grapple ends. It's not a grapple. Remember?
Read it for me one more time. Or is it on that card?
No, it's right here. Okay. The toad makes one bite attack against a medium or smaller target. Another humanoid. It's grappled. So once I did the attack, it's bite, right?
Mm-hmm.
It's grappled. If the target hits, the target is swallowed. So this is all just one motion, and the grapple ends. So once it's swallowed, there's no grapple, because it's not an opposed check. He's inside. The swallowed target is blinded and restrained, and has total cover against attacks from the outside. And it takes 10. It takes 3d6 acid damage at the start of each toad's turn. And I can only have one in. So I guess it can. I mean.
Okay, you know what?
It's blind and restrained, but it's not grappled. I don't know. The rules for restrained.
Even a restrained creature can attempt to break out.
It can attempt, but it has to break restrained before it can attack, right?
No, he can attack at disadvantage.
Yeah?
Yeah, from inside of you. So my question is, what is he going to do? He's going to try and fight his way out.
So his speed becomes zero, and he can't benefit from any bonus to his speed, attack rolls against a creature have advantage. The creature's attack roll have disadvantage. And he has any disadvantage.
If his speed is zero, he can't climb out.
Huh?
If his speed is zero.
He can't climb out. He can, I guess he can.
He can try to kill him from the inside.
I guess
but
he
that's
can try to poke
it.
Me, but his he has disadvantage, so he's going to have to roll.
Here we go. We start the rolls. What's the toad's AC?
11.
Okay, so he's going to get one hit from inside of you.
I don't think I've landed a single attack so far.
So you take 7 points of damage from inside as you,
seven.
You hear some pain. You feel some pain. Yeah. Okay. Now it's the other guy's turn, who will move straight towards Sprot. 2 more D4 damage for him. Aaron, Mr. Woods.
What is it now?
2 more D4 damage as he leaves the spiky pit that you made.
He just moved 1 5-foot?
He's out of the space, the threatened space after that.
But he just moved 1 to get out, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, okay.
Two points.
Okay.
Min damage.
And he pulls out a huge long sword, Mr. Sprot. Again. And he's just like, ka-ching, ka-ching, and it's bouncing off your armor as you smile at him, as you are doing. Conan.
Yay! Okay, so I'm posted up there. I'm looking up at Dexter. I'm just like, Jesus Christ, buddy, you have some issues. And I guess I can see that guy now.
Mm-hmm.
So instead of fighting on him, that's a 19. He's got to roll against it. I did it on his brother. I got to move.
Okay. Thank you for being honest. You're right. I remember that now. So he has to beat what?
19.
And he's doing wisdom, I think.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, he fails.
Okay. So I hit him. I hit him with the. Oh shit! What is going on? I hit him with the good old crossbow.
Mm-hmm.
14. So that hits 19.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, hey, just so you know that I'm just trying to full transparency. Whenever he stabbed me in the belly,
14 points of damage.
It attempted to end my concentration on the spike growth, but I just rolled a nat 20, so you might want to mark that down. If it would have broke it, I would have gave you the 2 points back.
I will say that with your nat 20 to maintain concentration, that you can redeploy that growth wherever you want.
Cool.
Oh,
Okay.
Also, when he started his turn in your belly, didn't he take acid damage? Did you say that was going to happen?
Yeah, on the start of his turn.
He took a turn inside
your
belly.
Oh, he did take
a
turn.
Let's roll that acid damage. And then while you draw that square, Conan, you going to move or do anything else?
No, I'm gonna kind of stay where I'm at. Stay,
you're
like,
you're moving over there.
Yeah, so he can't escape.
Okay.
I'm going to stay pop there.
It's a death trap.
All right, it's your turn, Woods.
Where'd he go? It's over there.
That's fine. I'll get another
one. I'm sorry, I got a piece of it.
Everyone wants to know that.
He had, at the start of his turn, he had 8 acid damage.
Okay.
I got 20 movement. 20 feet high.
So if this guy dies within your belly, will you have, like, successfully digested him?
I'll probably just throw him up.
Ah.
I wouldn't want to know how that works out if he transforms back into human form.
Uh-huh, yeah.
Yeah, no. I'm, take a bite at this guy real quick.
Well, not human.
Is 11 hit?
Negative.
No. All right.
These guys are beefy.
They are. And it's your turn.
All right. I'm going to turn around and stab him. Or not stab, shoot him.
Okay.
That is a 21. Finally hit him. It's a D10 plus 2.
Mm-hmm.
It's going to be 8 points of damage to him.
Nice.
And I'm going to try to convince... You know, now would be a good time to tell us what's going on here. So that, you know, you don't have to die. You really don't have to.
Because we don't get paid to give up information.
You don't get paid?
To give up information.
I mean, we can work that out.
You know, some of these new guys taking contracts would be all about that, but I'm old school. And he spits in your face.
All right. You're gonna die! I got a 9 to intimidate him.
Good job. He's very... he's like... Yeah, and you know... I guess I'm okay with that. you gonna do anything else?
No.
Okay.
No, we're beside each other.
It's their turn. Do some acid damage.
What are you, an acid toad? 9.
It's belly. Stomach acid.
Okay. Mm-hmm. 14 points of damage as it continues to slice you from the inside.
14?
Mm-hmm.
Speech.
Mm-hmm. And then you hear, what do you guys do? Oh, this is bad. Oh, Sue!
Oh, shit.
And in come the three... defense pigs with their goggles and their collars, these boars,
to join the battle.
Hog ops.
Yeah.
I got the fucking attack pigs. Of course, yeah. It's an attack pig.
Got them attack pigs.
They're smarter than dogs.
Okay.
I feel like I would have picked up on them coming toward me. I have like a 19 passive perception.
You did, but they just arrived. What's your AC?
15.
Okay, so one pig bites it or gores into you with his tusks. Doing 3 points of damage. The other one attempts to, but does no good. Frogman, what's your AC?
11.
Oh, was that a nat 1?
Yeah.
Oh, is this a creative?
Frogs don't have a lot of armor.
I mean, they're all the nat 1s mean something.
I forgot to do it, but concentration was a 17, so...
Oh, good.
Maintained it.
So he goes to nail you, and...
They all should have passed through, because they are coming from outside. All of these hogs, they weren't in the pen with us. They all passed through that.
No, they came the same way you came from earlier.
Oh, okay.
It's
open all on the sides. I thought we came from the big pen.
You did, yes. Yes. They came from around the other side. So not the same way you came, but from where you
There's another opening in the pen? Besides the one I smashed?
These pigs know the lay of the land.
Okay.
There are other ways in and out.
Okay.
These are their attack pigs.
Yeah, okay. I just figured
there was one entrance. So that's why I put that there, you know?
No. Okay. Much like at the fairgrounds, there are multiple entrances. Okay. So Nat 1, he goes to bite the frog and smashes into a pole instead, taking 4 points of damage. Jeez, okay. That hurts. And he's done. And Sprot, you haven't been swung on yet. That's what happens next. With a 19 AC. You take 5 points of damage from a long sword blow. And we move on to Conan. You're surrounded by 2 hogs in goggles with collars.
What's my... Is,
Is that a lightsaber?
It sounded like a lightsaber.
That's why I laughed at it. I was like, they have lightsabers too. These pigs have lightsabers.
Please don't do that. Now you're trying to kill us. is my back to a pin or to a?
Yeah, to a little
a corral.
Corral thing you were hiding under earlier.
So I can't slip through it.
No, not from this angle.
And I'm standing.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm going to
be open from the top.
I'm going to disengage.
It's like a lean-to. Mm. The front side is open.
I'm going to disengage, run around, and hop into it.
Okay. Yeah, you can do that. Boom. Okay. Cool. Done.
And then I'm going to shoot one of those pigs in the face.
Is that a called shot?
Yeah.
Well, if he rolls well enough, it'll hit him in the face. That's how I do those things.
13.
That'll hit.
Not 9 points of damage.
Cool.
Wait. Yeah.
Sure?
Yeah.
Okay. So you shoot that pig in the face, and it starts bleeding a lot and shaking its head. It looks real bad immediately.
That's good.
I think you've probably given it brain damage.
That's good.
What else are you going to do?
I'm just going to sit there and wait.
Okay. Woods?
Bite. Flip. No, I'm not.
Okay. So as you go to bite flip, you accidentally regurgitate flop instead.
Did I regurgitate it on his friend?
Yeah. Yeah, that's fair.
Okay.
That's fair.
So are they both prone?
Let's see. I'm going to give him... Okay, so he dives out of the way as flop comes sliding out, covered in slime and ooze. So put him prone.
Put flop.
Yeah, base. Yeah, exactly.
Did he leave my threatened square?
As we've said, he has to leave it willingly for you to attack him. Okay.
I'm going to use my bonus action to...
That was the number 10, by the way, which is why that happened.
Oh, okay.
It was a number 10 crit fail, so...
Oh, that's why that happened. Yes. That's why I go. Yes.
Otherwise, it would have just been something else.
I got you. I'm going to use my bonus action and eat a spell slot and regain D8 health.
In frog form.
In frog form, yeah. It's a wild-shaped thing.
Okay.
You know what I'm talking about?
Nope, but I trust you.
As an action. So yeah, strange. Yeah, so you can...
It must be in the...
Just so you know, because I've actually never done it before, but it's always been a thing of wild shape.
In wild shape, you can regain hit points as your wild shaped animal.
Yeah, because you can't use your spells
right.
wild shape. So you can burn your spell slots
to try to maintain your wild shape longer.
Yeah, as a bonus action to expend one spell slot, regain 1d8.
That's really cool. Because like if you're a bear and you're getting low, you're like, I want to stay in this form.
So I got 3.
Cool.
Got 3.
Very good. Are you going to do anything else?
That's it. That's my action and my bonus action.
Okay.
Actually, I'll move back.
No, I won't.
All right. Pigs. On you. On Frogman. What's your AC?
One pig on me?
Yeah.
11.
Okay. That's a hit. You take 3 points of damage from a pig. Okay.
Oh, yeah.
Yep. Both those pigs run around to the front of the pen to attack Conan.
So wait, you want to move them?
Well, I'm in a pen, though.
They move.
The front side's open.
Oh,
but they miss, so you're fine.
You want me to move this around to this side so it doesn't go through my space?
Yeah.
So you just corralled yourself?
Yeah. But it's fine. Neither one of them hit. Old boy stands up. So first we have 2 long sword attacks coming at Sprot. One of which connects. Sprot is taking 6 points of damage. Frogman, 2 misses. 2 wide misses.
I mean, they are
big. That's how you do it, boys.
I'm
a frog.
And you see him kind of shudder, and he's just like trying to wipe this gunk off of him. He's very displeased. And the longsword was slippery in his hand. He like almost dropped it twice. He's starting to question
this assignment. And we move on to Conan.
I think I got skipped. I'm going to try to...
You did. Go.
All right.
I don't know why I thought you went.
I'm going to shoot at Orange Man.
Uh-huh.
Orange Man bad.
Uh-huh.
That's going to be a 19.
Yeah.
That's 3 points of damage to him.
Okay. All right.
And nothing else.
I'm gonna try to telepathically, like, scold Conan and be like,
"Skull,
skull,
you're gonna scold me?
Be like, stop fucking with these pigs, man. We gotta get their masters.
They're like in his face now, though.
Stop fucking with these pigs. We need to get the masters. They'll go away.
They're attack pigs.
It is your turn. I yell. It is your turn, Conan. And you hear, Conan. It's gone wild down here at the station. The whole station is filled with these half pig, half gator abominations. Shit's gone wild. There's like dozens of these things. We couldn't stop them. They just busted in there. Ah!
Oh, jeez.
Did only he hear that?
Guys, they hit the station. Let's end this game and get back.
Well, let's get going.
So which one has the arrow in its face?
Oh, the pigs?
Yeah.
One right in front of you.
Okay. I shoot them again. Is that 14 points of damage?
Dead.
I mean, 14 to hit.
He's dead. He's dead.
Any hits?
If you hit him, he's dead.
And then I use crossbow expert to shoot at the other one. That's a 11?
Yes.
Okay. And then 7 points of damage.
He is also dead. You have murdered 2 of their guard pigs.
Terrible idea for an animal to guard. Like, they're not... I mean, I guess they're kind of fast.
They're boars. They're boars. They're not just pigs.
Oh, they didn't seem very aggressive.
I mean, hey, let's burn our house down. While we're out here.
Why would we...
I mean... She just attacked the station.
We'll do that for dramatic flair.
What else are you gonna do? You done?
I'm gonna run to the other side.
Did he kill his 2 pigs?
Yeah.
I'm gonna run to the other side of the stall and like kind of peek around that table.
I'm gonna keep him as
and kind of like post up and ready.
Cool.
My weapon. For the orange guy.
Dextar Woods.
Flop.
Frogman. Cometh.
Biting the guy right in front of me.
No, you're not.
I'm gonna use my movement, and frogs can do a standing leap, or the giant toad can do a standing leap. I'm gonna jump 20 foot high and land right on his head.
You will take an attack of opportunity from both of them.
It's fine. From the boar.
I was thinking the boar and him. Just from him. Yeah, from the boar too. But I mean,
is he in my spot?
The boar misses. That's a crit.
Okay.
So let's do this. Twelve points of damage to your frogman. As you leap up into the air and you're trying to come down on him and squash him.
Yeah, I'm just falling on him. It really shouldn't even be like a roll. It's like a...
Well, I mean, technically that'd be considered an attack.
Would it?
So what I'm going to do is give him a chance to
move
out of the way.
Evade, okay.
Yes.
You said 14, is that what you said? 14 points?
12. So he will attempt to not let your fat toad ass land on him. And he nat 20s.
Damn.
Which means that he sees you coming down and just points his sword up at you. Oh, he doesn't hit you though.
Oh, cool.
So you flop down right in front of him.
So if he's trying to point his sword up to me, he's under me.
Well, he was just like,
I got you.
He misjudged the distance.
He did, just barely, and he misses. Your AC is like, the frog's AC is like 11, you said?
11, yeah.
Yeah, he misses.
So you're gonna put, which way did he jump?
out of the way.
I mean, you could just move him back like 5 feet.
Then he moved 5 feet into the brush. The brush.
It's not there anymore.
Yeah, it's over there now.
It's not there anymore.
Oh, okay.
So, Sprotty Sprot.
All right. None of them are base to base with me right now.
Right.
Okay.
Orangey is. He got moved a little bit. I don't know how. Yeah. Well, he should be one forward, right next to Sprot.
Yeah. Okay. Cool.
Okay. I guess I'm gonna roll. How bad does this guy look in front of me?
They're both bloodied, but they don't look horrible.
Okay.
But they definitely have a lot of injuries.
All right. Well, I guess I'm gonna hit him again. 18 to hit.
Yeah.
It's gonna be 8 points of damage to him.
Okay. Good hit.
And I'm going to
jump up here and over the thing.
Mm-hmm.
Athletics, I guess.
Yeah.
A real poor, but not a one.
What do we got?
I rolled a natural 3, but I think it's a +3 for my athletics.
Okay, so there you stay.
Yeah. All right. That's all I got.
Okay. It's longsword time for this frog. How much HP does that frog have left?
Did you hit?
4 times.
I've got 5.
Okay. So,
Oh, you hit 4 times with both those guys, right? Yeah.
Yeah. So he had 5 left.
Mm-hmm.
So you're out of that form. You turn back into Dextar.
I'm back into Dextar, yeah.
What is Dextar's AC?
15.
Okay. All right, Dextar has... ...20 points of damage coming at him.
Whew.
As they just open you up with longsword attacks.
Damn.
And then little piggy.
Down.
He's down.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. Little piggy runs all the way over to Conan.
But
the last pig left and tries to bite you but doesn't.
So he's running through all the barriers?
He tries to break through, but just smashes into it and goes nowhere from there. Conan, it's your turn.
All right, so I still have my my insight for fighting on that one. Yeah, so
what? I ate up that whole round for you.
Thanks.
Luck. Not good enough. 11.
Fail.
Okay, and then I'm going to use my crossbow fighting. So I'm going to shoot him again. That also doesn't hit.
Who are you shooting for?
The guy that I have my insightful fighting on.
Oh, yeah, hell yeah.
It's just both of them, right?
Yeah.
Woods
it's just the one.
Woods' death saving throw. two failures. Sprot.
Oh.
Shit.
All right. I shoot at the most injured looking one of them.
Okay. That'll hit.
Okay. That's going to be 6 points of damage on him.
6 points of damage on Orangey?
The most injured looking one.
Yeah, he goes down.
All right, cool. At which point I jump up here and over... A natural 14.
That'll hit.
Alright.
Oh, that was just a jump. Uh-huh. Oh, yeah. You're going. You're speeding along.
Yeah. I come over here.
And actually, I'm gonna take that back. I'm gonna jump over here onto the other side of that, like right by that guy.
Okay, that's your turn.
Yeah. Hey, idiot! Look at me.
And he will. He's gonna swing at you and hit you once for 11 points of damage.
Jeez.
Yeah, he's a big hitter. Pig. Smash through gate. No. Conan, you have just seen Woods hit the ground face first in the muck. He is splayed open. There's blood pouring out of his body.
I'm gonna go run up to him and use a healing word.
Good. That's good. That's really good. It's really good.
For 1d4 plus 2.
That's good. That's excellent. Roll your d4.
That's 4 points of healing.
Thank God I was on two failures.
And you shake him awake, I assume?
Yeah. Look at you, buddy.
You gonna do anything else?
Crossbow expert. I'm gonna shoot that guy. 19. That hits.
Yep.
Four points.
He's still marked, isn't he?
Yeah. Do I get it on both shots? If I have him marked, it's still a sneak attack.
It's for a minute straight.
Yeah. No, it's
your extra damage and stuff.
Yeah, yeah. Okay.
That's what I'm saying.
That's 4 plus... That's 14 points of damage.
That does it. He goes down. Oh, there's still a pig left, and you're all screwed.
Don't kill that pig.
Talk to him. Talk to your boy. You better talk to your boy.
I'm going to use Beast and Leaf and, like, demoralize the pig. Right? I'm just going to, like, reassure it. I'm still, like, down.
Better talk to your boy.
Like, it's right beside me. I'm going to reach up and grab him by, like, a tusk.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to look at him, and I'm going to, like, shove his head over and look at the guys he was there. I'm going to shove his head back. I'm just gonna shake my head, speech of Beast and Leaf. Like, you're our pig now. We're your masters.
Persuade him. That just allows you to talk to him, right?
Yeah. Let me get my point across.
He turns and runs off.
That was a 12?
He got a natural 17.
Oh.
He turns and runs off.
Okay.
He didn't like this. He didn't jive.
Fine. I'm gonna search these dudes.
And then you hear
Oh, it's going real bad. And you hear smashes. And you hear, I'm going to lock myself in the cell with her. She's beastly, but I think I can, I can take her.
And guys. That's all you hear.
We are 45 minutes away.
Yeah.
We're 45 minutes
away
from
the thing. We need to take advantage of this opportunity.
And we'll see what you find on these bodies, which won't take up any time.
Okay.
We'll see what we find on these bodies next time. We'll see if you set the house on fire on the way out. We'll see if you make it back in time to save everyone at the police station. Not looking good.
It's not. Is it ever?
You really don't like using magic. That was like, oh shit. I was about to be dead.
Oh yeah, it's kudos to you and me. All I said was there's blood everywhere. Yeah. Neither one of us said, if you don't give him health right now, he could literally die on the next turn.
Kudos to you and him.
We didn't say anything.
We could have said he could die his next turn. But we didn't.
I mean, I knew.
See, but that's important.
That's why I ran over. It's like, hey, look at me.
Yeah, just let him die.
Yeah.
No, you could have just been like, you could have not been aware that he was one check away from dying. You could have been like, I'm going to shoot this
guy. Wait a minute. How did that boar run off? I had his tusk. I was holding his tusk.
You didn't grab and check it.
Oh, okay, you're right.
Basically touched him on the
it's
leg.
It's like,
yeah. Okay.
I wanted an attack thing.
Well, this is going to be so cool. You need to grapple him or make a better check.
He's going to search for troubles.
I said we'd make this our new home. Just fuck the city.
I'm just... no, there's some fucking...